G'day everyone, my name's Jonathan Owell. I'm the Curriculum Manager in Sustainability R12, the Department for Education and Child Development. As most of you know, we're known as Education and Child Development now, or ECD. I'm going to go through sustainability in the Australian curriculum. Most of you know that it's a cross-curriculum priority. We're going to go through, have a look at the website and find some different pathways to identify really interesting stuff for sustainability education. The first thing we'll do is put Australian curriculum into our browser and go to the new version of the Australian curriculum, which is Australian curriculum version 2.0. It has all of the finalised achievement standards in it, so what's in there now will be what's in there for the next year or so. Okay, so we come to the home page here, and I think it's important to have a look at the first page, because what it describes is why the Australian curriculum has been put in place and the role of the Australian curriculum in supporting all young Australians to become successful learners, become confident, creative individuals and active and informed citizens. When we're looking at the curriculum, we're not just looking at learning areas, we're looking at general capabilities here and cross-curriculum priorities as well as the learning area. So we'll come to that in a minute. But we'll just go through the structure of the website. If we go to curriculum first, you'll see on the screen the learning areas, English, math, science and history that have been completed, and the year levels on the right hand side. And you can use the search engine to go through either pathway. You can either go through a subject. So if we look at science, for example, click on science and the science page comes up. If you go to Foundation to Year 10 here, you can click there, and now you have the whole science curriculum on one page. There's a filtering mechanism here, and you can go to your particular year level. Maybe for these purposes, I'll identify Year 6, the strands. All of the strands in science are there, science understanding, science as a human endeavour and science inquiry skills. We'll have a look at all of those. General capabilities, you can select any of the seven or all of the general capabilities if you like. Literacy, intercultural understanding, personal and social competence, information and communication technology competence, critical and creative thinking, numeracy and ethical behaviour. For our purposes today, we won't identify any of the general capabilities, but because we're really focusing on sustainability, which is a cross-curriculum priority. So those three cross-curriculum priorities are here: sustainability, Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander histories and cultures, Asia, and Australia's engagement with Asia. We'll select sustainability for our purposes today. So what we've done is we're looking at Year 6 and sustainability. A nice little trick is if you look at the show button here, you can tick on show content description and show tags, and that just gives you more information when you come here to finally apply the filter. So I'll do that now. Click on the apply filter and it will give me the sustainability content descriptions for Year 6. We'll see here we've got the three columns: science understanding, science as a human endeavour and science inquiry skills. The icon here, which is a green leaf, is the sustainability icon. Once you've identified the content description that you're interested in, you click on the additional details tab and all of the information for that content description comes up on the screen. So for this one in Year 6, under science understanding and biological science, we're looking at the growth and survival of living things are affected by the physical conditions of their environment. So that's the content that you'll be focusing on for this particular description. And the elaborations on the right-hand side give you a guideline to some of the things that you might look at. Now, in science in particular, you'll find very close collaboration between these descriptions and primary connections. So that's one of the things that was one of the foci of the design of this, was that the primary connections resources would be closely aligned to this. So I think most of you will be happy to hear that. Okay, you'll see further down, we've also got the achievement standards. Now this is what we'll be assessing against. So if you look at the Year 6 achievement standards, for example, by the end of Year 6, students compare and classify different types of observable changes to materials. So in each of the achievement standards, you'll find the content descriptions above them will directly link to the achievement standards and what you can assess against for that particular learning area. Another way of searching the website is to go to curriculum and go by year level. So if once again we look at Year 6, click on Year 6 here, and you'll see the same filter is on this screen as well. We'll stick with science, but maybe we'll have a look at maths and history as well. Once again, we'll look at sustainability. We'll click on there and we'll apply the filter. Now you'll see here on the screen there are different views. At the moment, the view that I have is looking at learning areas consecutively down the page. What I might want to do is click on learning areas in columns across the page, and it'll show me the three learning areas that I've selected side by side. So now I can have a look at where sustainability fits in to the three learning areas from foundation year or reception year right through to year 10. So you'll see here under science, we've got the same content description that we had before, but alongside that we have the other two learning areas as well. So if we scroll down the page, we can see, in fact, in mathematics and history at year 6, none of the content descriptions have been tagged with sustainability. This doesn't mean that they can't be integrated into a cross-disciplinary approach. You can still use sustainability, say, for biological sciences, and use content descriptions from mathematics, history, or English to develop your learning plans. So that's really not a problem. I think it's really important to have a look at sustainability as a cross-curriculum priority and how it's described in the Australian curriculum. If we click on the tag here, come down to the sustainability link here, we have two pieces of text. The first piece of text is an overview, a description of what sustainability means. It's a really useful piece of text because what it highlights are the skills and values necessary for people to act in ways that contribute to more sustainable patterns of living, and that's really the guts of education for sustainability. The second part of the text are the organising ideas. These organising ideas have undergone a nationwide consultation in the final part of 2011, and what you see on the screen now will change a little in 2012, but the organisation of systems, worldview and futures will remain the same, and fundamentally the notions that are described here will be very similar. So if you're looking for design in learning areas with a basis of sustainability, or you're looking for multidisciplinary big ideas for your learning design, this is the place to start. We're really confident that these organising ideas have provided a framework to look at sustainability from reception right through to year 12 in the schooling system, no matter where you are and no matter what your local context is. In the near future, geography will be added as the fifth learning area, and after that, all of the other learning areas will be included. Geography will have many connections to sustainability, the cross-curriculum priority sustainability, and I think for those of you interested in education for sustainability, you'll find that a really great addition, not just for interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary teaching and learning, but also within the learning area of geography itself, there will be lots of opportunities to move forward with that. The last thing I wanted to do was just show you some changes to Scootle. Most of you will know Skootle as a repository of learning objects for Australian curriculum. What we have here now, you'll see Find by Australian Curriculum tag. The same filter that you saw on Australian Curriculum version 2.0 is here on Skootle. So if we scroll down to Science, for example, and click on there, you'll see on the left-hand page the same filtering system. So if I click on Year 6, we'll just look at sustainability today, but you can, of course, look at the general capabilities. And I click on sustainability and click apply filter. The Australian curriculum content descriptions come up. I want to have a look at that. And I want to have a look at some resources that match that. So over time, you'll see many new resources added to Skootle that directly link to the content descriptions in the Australian curriculum. So if we open one of these up, for example, you can use these whether you've got smart boards or computers or purely for lesson planning and design. You can use the Skootle website now. It's a fabulous addition to the suite of tools that you have for teaching and learning planning. Another element of Skootle are learning paths. If you click on the learning path tag, you can develop units of work where you pull different Skootle objects together into a learning pathway, and you can save them on your own Skootle website and use them for years to come. So I'm not going to go on about Skootle today, but I think if you have an account or you don't have an account, get onto Skootle, have a look at the links to the Australian curriculum, and I think you'll find some fabulous new additions to this site. Some significant investments are being made into Skootle, and it's becoming the central repository for data and for learning objects, especially for South Australia, but nationally as well. Okay, thanks everyone. It's been great talking to you. Bye.